Now at 11, they are annoying, invasive, nearly impossible to stop, it seems. We're talking about robocalls.
And tonight, Contact 5 investigator Michael Butchner shows you how some people are cashing in on those unwanted calls by utilizing a federal law.
Hello, this is Jonathan Smith.
Jonathan Smith of Fort Pierce is fighting back.
Every dollar that I get, I look at it as that's a dollar less than they had.
Against those annoying robocalls and telemarketers.
I'm cashing in on them for sure.
What's the biggest check that you've gotten from this?
26,000.
How many calls?
98.
Smith says he's collected tens of thousands of dollars.
Dear customer,
thanks to telemarketers calling and violating the Federal Telephone Consumer Protection Act.
Press 1 now.
Since the initial $1,500 check, how much money have you made?
Oh, I would say $35,000 to $40,000.
The only way to stop the calls is to make these guys pay.
Smith credits Doc Compton, the founder of robocalls.cash, with teaching him how to cash in on the calls for less than $50 using his kit.
What we as consumers can collect is roughly $500 to $3,000 per call, depending on the violations.
Why are they writing these checks so easily?
Because the cost of not writing them is greater.
Attorney David Lemos is working with Smith.
They will rather pay the small amounts of compensation per call on negotiation than get dragged into court.
Lemos says the first step for consumers looking to fight back is to get on the National Do Not Call Registry to set up a line of protection.
If you're on the Do Not Call Registry, it's like shooting fish in a barrel.
The Federal Communications Commission reports consumers received nearly 4 billion robocalls per month last year. The feds also received more than 500,000 complaints from Florida since January 2020.
Florida is definitely a hotbed for telemarketers.
It really does become a nuisance. It's rather annoying.
State Senator Bobby Powell says he gets about 10 robocalls daily. He co-sponsored legislation, which the governor signed into law, toughening the state's existing telemarketing laws.
We wanted to make sure that we put something in law that would allow for those of us here in the state of Florida who are tired of being annoyed.
Call immediately.
Do you think the laws are working to stop?
The laws are working. The laws are working, but not enough people are taking and using them, utilizing them.
What was your name again? Yes, I'm interested. I'd love to hear more.
Today, Smith's phone continues to ring.
Oh God, I still get them from the same companies I've already settled with.
Never really considered solar panels.
What was your name again?
Do you have a website or Better Business Bureau page?
And the checks keep coming.
If everybody would do their part, these companies would be put out of business quickly.
I really wasn't interested. I just needed to get the business name so I can send you a letter.
In Fort Pierce, Michael Butchner, WPTV News Channel 5.